Thousands are flocking to cemeteries nationwide to visit their departed loved ones this All Souls Day holiday. Let's get an update on the situation at the Manila South Cemetery, where over 500,000 visitors are expected to troop there. Andrea Taguinas joins us live from the Manila South Cemetery. Andy, what's happening so far?
Stanley, it's not even the end of the day yet, but the foot traffic here at the Manila South Cemetery has far exceeded the crowd estimate from yesterday, October 31. As of 3 p.m., authorities have tallied visitors of up to 76,000. And as the crowd gets thicker, we also see the lines for the bathrooms and the free e-trike rides get longer and longer. Earlier today, two metal staircases that crossed over the walls of the cemetery were installed along Metropolitan Avenue and Kalayaan Avenue in Makati with the goal of providing additional entry points for people visiting their departed loved ones. However, some senior citizens arrived even before the stairs were set up, so they still had to walk all the way to the main gate. Authorities also saw it fit to temporarily suspend the use of the stairs over at Metropolitan Avenue less than an hour since it was open to the public because of certain deficiencies like the lack of a railing on one side. One of the steps got broken already. There was also a gap between the stairs and the bridge at the top, which authorities said could potentially lead to an accident. This whole incident resulted in a lot of complaints by visitors, especially the dozens who had to wait by the sidewalk under the heat of the sun while the stairs were being fixed.
Naglakad kami from there hanggang dito. Eh, we are all senior citizens. Ang sabi ng mga polis, nagtanong kami, ginagawa pa daw. Sabi ko, late na. Dapat 1 ngayon, sapat nung 30 o 31 pa lang, ginawa na nila, para ganito.
Sabihin mo, tapusin na, kaya importante pagkadto sa cementerio. Hangka buwasan kami dito, hangka kainin namin.
Sana nag-provide sila ng service or ng e-bike. Di ba ganun yung parang, ano, kasi 1 year din naman itong pinag-prepare, di ba? So parang taon-taon naman nangyayari, pero bakit parang walang preparation, na parang walang contingency plan sa may mangyaring ganito?
Stanley, the management of the Manila South Cemetery has apologized for the inconvenience that the faulty stairs has caused to the public. But when we interviewed the director, Mr. Henry D., a while ago, he clarified that this is the initiative of the Makati City Local Government Unit. So they would first have to coordinate with them and see what went wrong with the planning of this project. Otherwise, he said they don't really have anything to do with it. But when we spoke to the Makati LGU, they said that this is actually, the metal stairs are actually a private sector initiative. So they're also washing their hands clean of that. And when we asked if the cemetery has plans to just build another gate or another entrance as suggested by some visitors so that there wouldn't be need for stairs, Henry D. said that they're not considering that option since they are more concerned about the safety and security of the people, which he said they can better monitor if there is only one entry and exit point. Meanwhile, Dee also reminded people to practice clay go or clean as you go during their stay here at the cemetery. Back to you, Stanley.
Yes, Andy, about the metal stairs, is there any formal advice now? I mean, they have to resolve the issue. They have to be clear about communicating if, in fact, those stairs are still available for use. Assuming that between now and for the rest of the evening, moving forwards, more people will still be going to visit their dead departed loved ones at the Makati South or Manila South Cemetery. So authorities there better be clear about those instructions.
Yes, Stanley, last time we checked, it was still being restricted for public use, but we'll try to see later on if it will be able to if they will be able to open it to the public as the crowds do get bigger and bigger here at the Manila South Cemetery.
All right, thank you so much for the update, Andrea Taguinas. Here we go to Marikina for an update on the situation at the Loyola Memorial Park. Lady Vicencio joins us for that. Lady, how are things there?
Stanley, more All Saints Day observers are arriving here at the Loyola Memorial Park in Marikina City as temperatures are expected to cool down this afternoon. As of this hour, the crowd estimate here in the cemetery is at 11,000 or 13,000 individuals, but visitors say it is less crowded this year. For motorists, this made it easier to navigate the traffic in the area. Last year's crowd for the All Saints holiday was at 100,000 goers. Some visitors say the lower turnout may be attributed to those who weren't able to make the trip from the provinces due to the recent weather disturbances. Aside from those who are visiting the graves of their departed loved ones, we are also expecting visitors to some notable personalities buried here at Loyola Memorial Park, including former Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago, master rapper Francis Magalona and host, and the master showman Herman Moreno. Marikina City Police also expect some visitors to stay here until midnight, with some families spending the night in the cemetery as tradition. The public is being reminded to avoid bringing weapons, alcoholic drinks, loudspeakers, and gambling materials, as this will all be confiscated by the entrance. For motorists, one-way traffic scheme is being implemented along A. Bonifacio Avenue and Sumulong Highway. For first aid response, medics are on standby and they advise the public to keep themselves hydrated as temperature remains high out of this moment here in Marikina City. Stanley?
Yes, lady, our authorities saying or getting a sense that, you know, their expected number of visitors at the Memorial Park has already peaked, or are they expecting more visitors tonight?
Yes, Stanley, as the temperature is expected to cool down this afternoon, the Marikina City Police said that they're expecting more goers here in the Loyola Memorial Park, especially around 6 p.m. until midnight. And aside from that, Stanley, they also reminded the public, although no untoward incidents has been recorded here in the cemetery, they again reminded the public to avoid bringing in illegal materials because earlier they already confiscated some illegal paraphernalias, including gambling paraphernalias, Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Lady Vicencio. Now over in Cebu City, the local government unit imposed new measures to ensure safety in this year's observance of the All Souls or All Saints Day holiday. Under the LGU's executive order, cemeteries will only be open until 10 in the evening, while vehicle parking inside cemeteries, memorial parks, and columbaries are not allowed. A task force was created to ensure the guidelines are being followed. Meanwhile, transportation hubs continue to be on heightened alert, particularly at the Mactan Cebu International Airport, the second busiest gateway in the country. Officials say they are expecting more travelers than last year due to the additional routes, both from domestic and international airlines.